Alright guys, we are all checked out from our hotel this morning. Had a quick breakfast in the Daily Grill. And now we are headed off to our surprise visit to Walt Disney Studios. We won't be able to take video while we're in there, but we'll be able to take as many photos as we like. Alright guys, we just finished with our tour. We're in the car now, leaving the lot. Amazing tour. Being able to walk into Walt's office almost the way he left it. They say that the office itself is about 98% accurate. The only place that's they're still working on is the reception area. But so cool, so cool. If you've ever seen Saving Mr. Banks, you'll see similarities to that, although Saving Mr. Banks was shot on a set in those scenes, inspired by the suite and pictures and everything from that that area. So hope you enjoyed the pictures. We're now off to Disney's California Adventure. We're going to see if we can stop at our hotel first. We're going to be staying at the JW Marriott. Alright guys, so we've checked into our room here at the JW Marriott in Anaheim. And behind me here you can see a little bit of Disney's California Adventure. We're about a third of the mile from the front gate, so we'll be walking over there in a bit. But check out the view. Take a walk around the room. This is a standard room. Of course, JW Marriott is a much nicer hotel. This was kind of a splurge for us. But we'll take a look around. So this is our entrance. Nice big mirror here. We'll start with the bathroom. Toilet, big glass shower with a what looks to be a rain nozzle, as well as a handheld. Big soaking tub. And the vanity. We have out here, we have typical mini bar set up. TV, desk, and two beds. Nice modern look. And even with the standard room, I have to say, it's a great view. We're up on the 7th floor. And it was a nice splurge for our little weekend trip here. All right, guys, we have made it down to the Esplanade here at Disneyland and Disney's California Adventure. Spin around here so you can see. So that was about a 10-minute walk from the hotel. I'd say one thing they have to work on here is security. Disney World, you have those AI-based scanners where you can just walk through. Here, they're still doing handbag searches. So something to improve. Of course, they don't have touch points either, but I'm sure they're working on that. All right, and just like that, we are in DCA. Now, when DCA was opened, it was strictly a park dedicated to California. Main entryway, you had that big Golden Gate Bridge right over the walkway. And out by the Esplanade, you had the letters spelling California. So, parks changed quite a bit since. More refined, more Disneyfied. We're gonna see what we can do here today. This is our first time at the park. Of course, going on right now is Disney's California Adventure Food and Wine Festival. We got at least one of the things that was from a cart. We've got a barbecue brisket slider. Mm-hmm. Is that what that is?
Yep.
Okay. And I just went with the corn dog for now. Throughout the day, we'll probably be grabbing some of those offerings from the booths around California Adventure. All right, so we decided to walk over to Cars Land, and you may remember from some very early videos, we actually stayed at Art of Animation, Walt Disney World, and they do have a Cars-themed area, and so the vibe is very similar. But it's like you're walking into Radiator Springs. It really is. We'll have to come back at night as well, when all of the neon is all lit up. But it is really just an amazing atmosphere. Alright, so now we're loaded onto Rollickin' Roadsters here in Cars Land.
Oh,
Uh-oh, ride just stopped.
Hi there, please, put on your seatbelt.
That was super fun, guys. The ride did get paused kind of in the middle of the song. I suspect that somebody maybe stood up or moved or something, because they immediately did a seatbelt check. But they got it right rolling again, and great ride, super fun. If you guys know the dance academy scene in Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway, kind of like that, not as violent. So awesome for all ages. We're gonna head over to Radiator Springs Racers next, as we have a lightning lane. And for a little history point, this is the same track system and vehicle system as Test Track in Epcot at Disney World.
Together, and go on.
guys. Coming out of Radiator Springs Racers now. That was super fun. To give you a gist of what the ride's about is you go through getting ready to race, and then you pull up alongside another vehicle, and yeah, you race. We won, so that was fun. But yeah, it's super, super fun tracked ride, just like a test track, but there's two vehicles on the track. Alright guys, we just got off of Incredicoaster behind us. Awesome coaster. I can see why people say some of the theming is a little cheesy, but it's a great ride if you're a coaster fan. Has one inversion, plenty of banking, and nice little bunny hops as well. So. Cool coaster, and we're gonna see what's next. Really enjoying the vibe here in California Adventure. Really laid back vibe, just as if you were say at the boardwalk or something like that. All they need is to make it smell like the ocean. But we're having a great time here. So we were in line for the Pixar Pal Around, the old Mickey's Fun Wheel, which is the swinging cabin Ferris wheel at the heart of DCA. But it just went down and we were asked to get out of line. I have to say it was probably a better thing that it broke down with us in line and not on it. Because who knows how long it's going to take to clear everybody off. We're going to make our way over towards the front of the park now and try some other stuff. All right, so that was cool. Just like you can get a baguette in France at Epcot, you can come here and get a loaf of sourdough, fresh baked. They've got Mickey shaped ones. Oh, look at that. That is cool. All right, guys, we are now in the Hollywood section of California Adventure. It is giving us major MGM Studios vibes with the old streets. Although this is more California and Hollywood themed, it's nice to reminisce. Oh. We're outside of Monsters, Inc. We're going to do a quick little history lesson before we go in. This was originally Superstar Limo when the park opened, and it was about running away from the paparazzi in your limo. Now, of course, that was about the time that Princess Diana unfortunately passed away in a car accident. So it was quickly rethemed as soon as Disney was able to do that. And today it is a Monsters, Inc. themed ride called Mike and Sully to the Rescue.
If you are new to the area, the Monstropolis Chamber of Commerce would like to welcome you. While you're in town, be sure to...
We interrupt this program for a special report. A child is on the loose in Monstropolis. A human child!
If witnesses are to be believed, there has been a child security breach for the first time in monster history.
We can neither confirm nor deny the presence of a human child here tonight.
I tried to run from it, but it picked me up with its mind powers and shook me like a doll.
It's true! I saw the whole thing!
Happy birthday,
Smokey
Poe!
Oh, good
evening!
I
have a human child frozen
with its telepathic control. It made me dance like a chicken. My thoughts were not my own. Then it grabbed me with a giant fork.
Oh, boo, we gotta get you home.
Uh-oh. There's a kid here! A human kid!
Travel in comfort, speed, and safety, which is our motto here at the Red Car Trolley. What's a motto? Nothing. What's a motto with you? I took that one from Timon. Well, speaking of Timon, coming up here on the trolley's left-hand side is our Disney Animation Building. And inside there, you can learn how to draw different Disney characters. Or maybe if you wanted to learn how to talk like a sea turtle from Crush the Sea Turtle from Finding Nemo. Or maybe you wanted to meet some Arendellian royalty during the day. I think they've already went home for the day. But during the morning, if you want to visit any Arendellian royalty, that's where you would go. Now, over here on the trolley's right-hand side is Mickey's PhilharMagic. It's a really cool 3D concert That's only lasts about 12 minutes long, and if you're ever starting to feel a little chilly from the weather, that's one of the best places to go to get to hide from the weather. Now, on the left-hand side is our Disney Junior dance party. They've finished with all their dance parties for the day, but I want to talk about how the building itself is actually inspired by the original ABC radio building that was built in the 1940s. That's right, it's just as old as our friendship, right, Lindsay?
Almost.
We're not that old, I promise. All right, on the trolley's right-hand side is our popcorn cart. Now, it's one of the, and we love talking about that popcorn cart because it's one of the only ones in the resort to pop caramel corn. Freshly made, by the way. So you can also get buttered popcorn and caramel corn all in a half and half bucket. Here at the trolley, we love to call that an Arnold Popper. But don't order it like that, because look at you kind of weird. Trust me, I already tried multiple times. Now we are approaching our first courtesy stop here. We're going to ask everyone please remain seated until the trolley makes a complete stop. The doors open and the lights turn on. If I happen to entice you with the word Starbucks, you'll notice that'll be across the street.
So we're just watching through the Grizzly Peak area now, and I have to say I'm getting major Yosemite National Park vibes. I'm sure there were a number of national parks considered in this. Like right now we're up to the Rapids area in like the Springs, and that is probably more reminiscent of Yellowstone. I just love Yosemite. It holds a special place in my heart. In 2019, I was able to climb Half Dome. And so this is really cool. So we weren't sure exactly what to do for dinner tonight. It looks like we're gonna do dinner here at the Grand Californian Lodge, which is a hotel inside of Disney's California Adventure. It's also a DVC property. So tonight we're having a quick dinner over at the Craftsman Bar here at Disney's Grand Californian. This is their pool bar. So you can see behind us the pool. They also have live music going on right now. We waited about 20 minutes to get our seats, so not bad at all. So check for walk-ups if you're in Disney's California Adventure. There's several restaurants in the Grand Californian, and I don't think you could go wrong with any of them. All right, great little night here at the pool bar at Grand Californian. I had a poke bowl. Ashley had had the nachos, which was way more than just one person needed to have. Probably enough for about four people. I think we're gonna go over to the gift shop real quick to see if we can find a phone cable for myself, because I left it in the car, which is in valet. I need to charge up, so I'm gonna see if we can find that real quick before we head back into the park. So another tip as we head back into California Adventure here, keep your eyes open. You never know who you're gonna see. We saw two parties having dinner that had a security detail. Nobody we recognized, but I'd imagine they're because of the proximity to LA, there's probably a number of high-profile individuals here on a daily basis. All right, so we're back in Cars Land at night. We wanted to see the neon and everything, but we saw that Mater's Junkyard Jamboree is a 10-minute wait, so we're going to hop on. For those that have been on the Alien Swirling Saucers in Disney World at Hollywood Studios, this is a very similar ride system, so it'll feel pretty similar.
Hey everybody, come greet you!
So we just found out that web slingers over on the, I guess the Avengers campus area of California Adventure has reopened. Earlier we had a lightning lean for it, and it went down. So we got a multiple experience pass, which we can use at any time in the next day. But we decided we do need something to do before World of Color tonight. So we're going to try out web slingers. I doubt that I'm going to be able to film it because I believe it is a 3D attraction. So we'll let you know how it goes. All right, so we just got off web slingers. We're making our way over to World of Color now. I'd say concept-wise, very similar to Midway Mania, Toy Story Midway Mania, except you're not using a gun or a launcher or anything like that. It's completely with your arm motions. So it's really cool, very interactive. Our car got 669,000. We're gonna find a good spot for World of Color and see how much of that we can get. So one of the things we decided on tonight was we're gonna use some Disney World logic here. Most young families are gonna go to the first showing of anything. Second showing is going to be less crowded. So we're going to the 10:15 show of World of Color. We're coming up into the area now. And enjoy.
Appreciate and accept what I've done all these years. That is a great reward.
One man, one dream. 100 years ago, Walt Disney set ripples of happiness and imagination in motion. He showed us how little ripples can become great waves. It just takes one.
A dream is calling out.
Hope lighting up that dark.
A single act of love.
Just imagine all the ways that it could start.
You'd be the one to start.
Start the motion, stand alone. Stir the ocean, be the hand that reaches out to the unknown.
Spirits, child, if you listen, they will guide you.
And just like that, we're going to close out the night here. We'll see you bright and early tomorrow morning for a full day at Disneyland. Have a great night.